In this video, we look at the new rubric experience, which is an opt-in feature at Pima Community College. We'll look at how the tool has improved, and we'll begin with a brief summary of the tool and then get into the details of how it has shifted. So let's first begin with why we use rubrics in the first place. Perhaps you're already using rubrics quite a bit, perhaps you're not. Here's a few reasons that might interest you if you're not using them. So first, rubrics can help set clear expectations if we show those rubrics to our students in advance of the assignment. They know how their work is going to be assessed. Likewise, it can be a tool for self-monitoring. In other words, if a student has an assignment and they need to review their work, they can use the rubric to help consider how they want to revise their work. In terms of our instruction, it can help us to be more fair and consistent with our grading, and it can also save us time. So, again, keep in mind the new tool is enabled at Pima if you opt in. The first time that you go back into the rubrics experience, you'll see this new pop-up that'll ask you to leave on the new experience or turn it off. We encourage you to click the blue button and leave it on. But again, you can revert to the old version if you'd like to. There's a downward arrow in the right margin that allows you to do so. In terms of the core features of this new design, it's really about ease of use. All design tabs are consolidated into one screen, and it's a lot easier to edit. As we work, it auto-saves. We can simply click on the text in order to edit, and we simply click on the arrow to change the actual type. So this is the vision of how it used to work. Properties tab and a level and criterias tab with a lot of options that you had to look at. Now it's a clean single screen. It's quite simplified. As we work, it tells us that it's either saving or it's saved the work that we've put onto the page so far. As we work, we can simply click on the text to edit it. For example, if the performance level in the rubric was a level 3, we can click on it and give that a name instead of the generic level 3 to reflect the quality or performance level. Another cool thing about the design, we can now shift from analytic to holistic and back again. And the ease in which we edit it is simply a matter of these drop-down arrows. Let's walk through them very quickly. So again, analytic, we click on the arrow to that or to the points or to the reverse level order, and it automatically shifts it, for example, from analytic to holistic, or in this case, percentage to no score, and it can reverse the order of the levels just like it always was able to do. So pretty cool stuff. We'll also notice that these options, the advanced options, are still there, but they're kind of tucked away. If you click on that triangle in the right margin, you'll see the same pop-up window that reflects all the previous options. So they're not gone, but they're just the default options and they're hidden from view so they don't overwhelm us. That's the heart of it. Now let's take a moment to get into the details. The main thing to look at in terms of how we design, the rubric type used to be fixed when we were designing. Once we set it up initially, it was going to stay. Now, with the new version, it's flexible. You can shift from analytic to holistic and back again. As we're grading or assessing, the old version used to have this side column that was, frankly, hard to fit onto the screen because there were so many columns, especially on a smaller laptop. So now that column is not taking up screen space. You also don't have to have this pop-up that is taking up screen space. Those are some exciting things. I should also note that the HTML editing features for the individual feedback on those criterion took up a bunch of space too, so they decided to let go of that, given that it was rarely used and it took up a lot of space. So finally, at the bottom of each rubric is a checkbox that used to be there that said transfer rubric feedback because it wasn't automatic, but that's shifted. So in the new version, these are replaced with something quite simple, which is an add feedback button, which is underneath every single criterion row that allows you to add text feedback. Again, that's not HTML feedback, it's text feedback. And so you can see with the second arrow at on this page, I've typed in some sample feedback that reflects where you would be typing in feedback to the students. It is text only. It's clean, tidy, and easy to use. There's an easier scoring convention now in terms of, again, clicking on the text to edit it. You can simply click on the total score and change your 3 to a 3.5, for example, like I've done here. Students are now able to view both the criterion feedback and the rubric within the gradebook. So it's easier for the student and it's easier for the instructor. Some other improvements to keep note of. Previously, there were two places for overall feedback. That led to some confusion in the old model. So in the new model, all overall feedback, I should say, will just be going in one location, which is just in that feedback box. The criterion feedback for each row of the rubric stays within the rubric. The overall feedback goes within this box. Finally, some other details that is a rare use case, but if you use multiple rubrics for single assignments, now D2L clarifies which rubric is driving the score. And now, as well, the icons within Gradle are consolidated. In terms of what hasn't changed, I would say most of it hasn't changed. It still gives you a 3x4 rubric. It still gives you a 4-3-2-1 level ordering, starting with the highest. And it still locks the rubric once you start grading with it. So again, you can't edit this once you're grading with it, but that is a safety feature. This marks the end of our video on the new rubrics experience. As you continue to learn more about how to utilize D2L to support online, hybrid, and face-to-face teaching, we hope you'll visit our Brightspace faculty guide, which includes helpful tips as well as training opportunities so that you can continue to learn more about D2L through D2L or right here through Pima Community College.